Hello, I'm Mike, and today we're going to be looking at the differences between Python and Java. Both Java and Python are incredibly versatile and often used for web and mobile applications, games, multimedia, and business tools. In this video, we will compare Python and Java, and we'll dig into how these languages interact with WordPress sites, perhaps helping you decide which one is right for you. But before we get started, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's look at some key differences between Python and Java. Python is simple to use. You just need to download and install Python on your local machine. Once that's done, you can run Python scripts from a terminal anywhere in your system. Python also includes PIP, a package manager for installing third-party code. Java has a steeper learning curve than Python. It's more difficult to install and set up, as you need to install a Java development kit and the included Java runtime environment to compile and run the code locally. When comparing Python and Java, you can expect the latter to be faster because Java uses static binding as opposed to Python's dynamic binding. Take the calling of a function, for example. When Python calls a function, it takes its name in string format and searches the dictionary to find the actual callable body. It does this every time a function is invoked. In contrast, Java simply goes through its virtual method table to locate the nth slot. In general, Java's process is faster because it has less abstraction than Python's. Python is inarguably one of the easiest programming languages to learn. Its syntax is very simple, concise, and in many ways resembles the English language. To compare both syntaxes, take a look at the following code snippets, which demonstrate declaring some data and printing it on the console. In Python, this takes only a few lines of code. Java's syntax is more complex. It requires knowledge of classes and OOP, including keywords like public, main, protected, and so on. Additionally, Java is strongly typed, meaning variables must have a corresponding type declaration. Java programs also take up more lines of code than many other languages. Here's the equivalent of the same Python program in Java. Because Java is class-based, you must create a new class to contain your data and methods. As a result, even a simple program can require more code. In this code, two lines of code were required to declare the variable and assign its data. In Python, one line of code accomplished both. Additionally, we imported the HashMap class in this Java code to help create our data structure. In Java, built-in libraries must be imported for them to be used. Python is one of the main languages for data scientists and engineers. Some of the popular libraries and frameworks for Python are listed here. Java is frequently used for developing desktop applications, but it also has libraries for a variety of other purposes. Many of its libraries are geared toward web and mobile development. Here are some of the popular Java libraries. WordPress uses four primary markup or programming languages: HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and PHP. HTML and CSS are used to design the front end of the website. JavaScript is used for front end programming, and PHP is used in the back end for server side scripting and interacting with the database, which could be MySQL, MariaDB, or something else. Apart from PHP, you can use server-side programming languages like Java and Python to interact with WordPress sites via the WordPress REST API. The WordPress REST API provides a set of endpoints that applications can call to interact and exchange data with a WordPress site. This data is usually stored in JSON object format. This means you can build a server-side application using Python or Java to query the WordPress REST API on demand. You can create, read, update, and delete information on the WordPress site by calling the respective endpoint in your app. For example, here's a sample CURL request to create a new post in WordPress. You can make requests to the WordPress API from Java backends to either retrieve information from a WordPress site, create a new one, or update an existing one. You just need to make a request to the corresponding API endpoint. The following Java code would retrieve all of the posts from a WordPress site. You can use Python to access WordPress using the WordPress REST API. The following code gets and prints to the screen all the posts from a WordPress site that doesn't require a password-protected login. You can also run Python scripts from your WordPress site, but this is only possible if a Python compiler is installed on the server. The same goes for Java. To run Java in WordPress, you need JDK installed on your local machine. Then you can execute a Java C and Java command from a PHP program like functions.php. While both Python and JavaScript use API to update WordPress sites from their native backends, Python has a slight advantage due to its ease of using scripts. Here at Kinsta, we take hosting and performance to the next level. With our application hosting, you can run almost any app in a matter of minutes with full support for all your favorite languages and frameworks. And our database hosting allows for easy database creation with full control over every aspect of your project. Explore these features and more at kinsta.com/application-hosting. Thank you so much for watching. And if you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.